Good day, welcome to Revit tutorial from Martinez Business and Design to Martinez Media. In this tutorial, this is one of my biggest tutorial I did for a client some years ago when I performed this particular design with Revit 2015. Something like 6 years ago. But I want to bring it to tutorial to teach people how to design hotel. So I design a lot of things by when my client give me the surface plan, it's kind of a funny shape that I have to implement this kind of shape into it and give a lot of features. So in this hotel, we have good ground floor, we have kitchen, the log restaurant, especially swimming pool where people can sit down and do a lot of things all for it. So a lot of criteria that the client gave me, so I want to implement in this tutorial and teach people. So what you need to do is to sit down completely, give yourself a lot of time, watch this tutorial, every series of it from one or the other to the time we are going to combine everything together. So it's going to be a helpful tutorial for you if you are a beginner as an architect, or definitely you're a professional but you are lagging behind in area of some certain criteria of commercial buildings. So this is the first floor, what hotel entails. Those are the things that we are going to demonstrate and pick up and start here. So in the second floor, a lot of things are implemented as well, the repetition of the bedroom and the complement of all these things. So we have a lot to the third floor, including the 10th floor. So most especially, I'm going to teach you how I was able to create this kind of roof. They are all single roof, they are combined with gable and eave. So I'm going to teach you how I created everything from beginning to the end. And this same time, the elevations, approach, how it looks, and whenever you look at it from the perspective of point of view like this, so you're going to get. So I've modernized this and give some clients, but I don't want to reveal it yet. This is a particular tutorial features, so I want you to come into this and demonstrate it. So I did a lot of 3D as well at the same time. So I'm going to teach you how I created everything. I'm going to modernize so many things here. So what you just need to do is to follow this tutorial right from this present moment to the time we are going to create something. So we are not going to limit our floor to this just two-story building. We are still going to more. I'm going to make it a more fantastic high-rise building and create a lot of modern-day development. So what you need to do is to come to. If you have never been a good subscriber to our channel before, or what you join it here now is that you click to the Martinez and kindly subscribe to our channel by clicking subscribe button on our channel, so you'll be able to learn this mega hotel tutorial 2023 Revit. So that will be a lot of helpful things for you to do. So now what we do here is that we are starting this experiment from beginning. So what you need to do is to go to file, click on new. From there you click on template. I have my own personal template, which is Martinez design template, which I used to use. So click on that. If there's anything I want to use that I did not get, I'll come back to it and start afresh. So this one will be a beautiful approach to design that we are going to about to start. So the first thing to do is to start the orientation of what we have been taught about. So from the 3D that I showed you, or from the former plan level, what I need to do is to go back there. If I go back there, I want to go and copy the surface plan. So you don't need to write another surface plan here again. So I'm clicking on it, click on finish, is the surface plan. So what you need to do is to click on clipboard. After you click on clipboard, go back. Since the beauty of a Revit 20 is that you have this in place. So what you do, your new what is it called? Your new project that you have created, or if you have never created anyone, you start anew, like I've done here. So what you create here, this is the former one, click close. So what you just need to do is to bring this into BL, click on modify, paste from clipboard, and say align to the level, or align to the selected level, or align to current view. So whatsoever you need to do, just click OK. It's going to bring it to you. This is what you have brought. So what you need to do is that you go to site plan. Can you still see this? Yes, it's there. If you go to foundation plan, is it feasible? Everything is feasible because it's a 3D. It's a model line solidification material. So what you do here is that according to the software plan that this client has given you, we want to demonstrate a lot of things that we have done there. So we're starting our plan here. But before we do that, what we need to call for is to save your project and say click save as. As you click save the project, look for the folder to create, because we are teaching here complete how to start a project from beginning to end. So create new folder. As you create new folder, call this one hotel design. Depends on the way you want to name your design. So copy this, Ctrl C, click on this. So you are ready in hotel design. So you paste this into this place, click, then you say hotel design. I call it tutorial. Hotel design tutorial. So from polygon 23. So you get to understand what you are doing, because this is a tutorial for me. It's not a real project. If you have a project, you can name it according to your client or the software plan, whatever that is there for you. So this is what, so I'm starting this project from the beginning. So the first thing I need to do is to understand the setback, and I'm not going to be doing that by putting lines. So I'm going to start it straight away with what, with walls. So I'm creating or clicking on wall. My wall is 3000 in height. If you have never gotten that one, you can check most of our tutorial that we have done on the on this channel, and you see the way we set all this title bars at the same time, all this property, and we set every element property one after the other. So I'm going to use this because this is actually I've been set because of my template that I'm using. So now what I need to do is to start creating my walls. So from here I want to create a wall which is from down to somewhere here. So this wall, when you click on it, indicates, so it's telling you that the width of the wall is something minor. So you click here if you have any other one that are already bigger. So I have some that have already been created, which is wall generic, which is wall 2 mm. So you can imagine the width. So you click on this and edit it 2 to 5. So okay, let it bump up. Good. To change this wall particularly, so this one now I want to start creating everything one after the other. As I've done here, the next thing to do is that I want to create the kitchen. So I don't want to use any diagonal something because I want them to be a complete package of design. I will have rotated this, but I want you to follow. I will have rotated the sign for you to see, but I want you to follow. I want you to design with this kind of view in mind. It's going to help you, it's going to help your graphics ability. So what you do now is that align this, because this is what your wall of reference. When you align that, click on this wall that is parallel. The next thing to do is to make sure that you sift it away from the wall. So just type 4900. So you see, then you click here and you look at its offset. So what is the offset from the boundary. That is what you have done here. So this one you have offset this. So here the kitchen and laundry is situated, so you click on there and do the same thing. Okay, the same thing here. You have some rooms, to be precise, things like that. This is not the end of what you are doing, but this is just the beginning of your what, of your design pattern. So you do some crazy activities here, because you remember this is where you want to situate your semi-pool is going to be here at this point. We are going to do that one after the other, so follow through, and most especially click on our subscribe button, follow this channel, because there are a lot of things we are bringing to board. So this is all wing. So this wing belongs to her. So by the time we finish everything one after the other, you are going to see how beautiful the whole design is. This will be the entrance, and we're going to adjust everything accordingly, bring them to the same pattern. So adjust this, let it be aligned. So click. So that's what you are doing here. So the next thing is that this wall, they are not parallel to, are not the right, at the right angle. So what you do is that you adjust it to the very point that you are going to get angle that is suitable and demonstrable. Like this now shows that okay, those two broken lines that are in right angle to that the whole design at a right angle triangle. So if you put, now let us demonstrate something by changing the angle dimension. Click here and click here, and you see at 90 degrees. So right angle triangle. So if you want, these ones are not there. If you click on this one, you are going to see that's going to have some disparity. Can you see? So it's different from this one. So that's why you need to do what? Understand the fundamental of Revit. Because everything is on formula. The program of Revit is a suitable program that demonstrates that. So you can adjust this one. The moment you're adjusting it, let's look at the broken lines that are appearing a day of the sale. So when you look at it that way, you see that this one too is going to become right angle triangle. I don't know whether you get what I'm talking about here, but let me tell you from here. And at this point, when you click on angle dimensions, click here and you align it here. Are you seeing the disparity? So if you want to adjust your wall, you click on this, then start swinging it, change the direction. The moment you see the broken line of the vertical one, and you're looking at another broken line of horizontal, there are the two broken lines appear, one vertical, one horizontal, that tells you that this lines are at right angle triangle to one another. So you need to do what, to release it at that point. When you release it at that point, can you see that this thing has changed from 88.80 degrees to 90 degrees perfectly? So that is what I'm trying to tell you. So if you want your design to be accurate, so that by the time you are doing dimension, you're going to have accurate dimension, that is what you need to follow. So that's why I say you should watch this program from beginning to end. Do not skip it. It's not going to be boring. You are going to enjoy it from beginning to the end. So adjust this one the way I have done to that one as well. So are you seeing it? So release it. So everything is being closed. Do the same thing here. So you are able to get in touch with what you want to get in touch with. So this is the hall that we have created. And we are proud that this hall is in a good place to start with. Can you see the dimension is going to be regular? It's not going to have some issues because of what they have the right angle to one another. So that is what to do here. This is the beginning of the tutorial. All what you just need to do is to click on subscribe button here, and everything is going to be continue flowing to. So we are continuing with our design here. So you have said this is a kitchen. Click on this, know the dimension of what you are doing. If it's okay by you, right, continue. So click on the wall, and create similar from this upper point. Let it align because you need to still work because of your structure. You know, when you are doing high-rise building, you need to consider structural elements with it. So that will give you the idea of what you are going to do, because by the time you are designed, you should have your structural engineer in your mind that this is who you are, that's going to help you get so many of this structural design done. So we have done that. This is kitchen, this is entrance to laundry, or this is laundry, this is kitchen, depends on the way you are arranging your drawing. So as I have it that way, then I want to create what, stair hall. In the stair hall, I'm creating something like this. So I will break this into two because I want it to have its own space to work with. So I'll break that, okay, extend it as well. So can you three? So with this one, we're going to have two staircases. Another one will be situated somewhere here that will go up, something that's outside before the entrance. So from there we have all we go to have entrance of its own and things like that. So this is just the beginning of the tutorial. We are not going to do much in this place, it's an introduction. So what you need to do here is that you follow us through from day one. Kindly subscribe to our button, click on it, because tomorrow we are bringing the next tutorial, which is going to happen a bit after 24 hours. We are going to bring you the details of this floor plan. We are going to demonstrate it one after the other here, putting door and everything. So we are not going to hide anything for you in this design. So thanks.